So good morning, one and all. Myself, Guda Karthik, Technical Manager, Design Tech Systems Limited, Hyderabad. So I'm located at Hyderabad. So I'll take care of technical support activities for all the customers who all are using Altair HyperWorks as a software. So like most of our customers are defense organizations, public sectors, and private sectors. So today, as per the agenda, today's session is on digital technologies in design and manufacturing systems. So regarding that, we are going to discuss about the 2-hour sessions today. Coming to Design Tech Systems Limited, so Design Tech Systems is located in Pune. It's a Pune-based company. We are into product sales, mainly into product sales, and among the top most 3 CAD/CAM and CI/PLM solutions. So we are the resellers for them. So that throughout India, we sell the product like ProE, Creo, we'll call us, and MathWorks. We also do product sales for that. And Altair HyperWorks is another one. And Bentley software for civil engineering structures. And 3DCS for geometric tolerances and manufacturing related tool. Okay. And Stratasys is a plastic 3D printing machine. It's a powder-based machine that also we sell into the market of the into the industries. And apart from that, SLM is a machine. It's a metal printing machine. So that is the current trend is going on in the market. So where directly going to the conventional manufacturing, so they are going for the SLM, additive manufacturing technology. In the industry. So SLM is one of the company where they produce many metal printing machines with a different type of materials in the requirement of the customers. So they develop and they'll do the sale. So Design Tech is a partner for all these products. Apart from that, Design Tech is into engineering services. So we have engineering services around 600 plus employees are working as engineering services. So where we take projects from the industries and we complete that and we'll submit the results to the customers. That is one area. And other area is we are into training center as well. It's called Design Tech CAD Academy, where we train our faculty, research scholars, students, okay, private sectors. If anyone is newly joined in the company, so those guys, like if they want to learn the software, the companies will contact us. So we'll give some private trainings also to the customers. So this is our area of work as a Design Tech Systems Limited. Okay, ours Design Tech is into 10 places in India. Hyderabad is one location. Pune is a head office, and remaining 8 locations are there in India. As I said, Delhi, Chennai, Mumbai, Kolkata, Ahmedabad, Gujarat. So these are all our centers in India. Apart from India, we are in USA, Canada also. In Singapore also, we have recently opened an office. So ours is old organization, I can say, from 1985. We have started our journey and we are going on improving the product line as well as the engineering services capability as well. So nowadays, the current trend is going on into a digital manufacturing, digital technologies in engineering. Okay, so we are talking about we are discussing about that particular technologies. What is exactly the digital manufacturing? What are digital technologies in design is going on in the current industry? So that we are going to discuss today. So coming to the what is digital manufacturing, before getting into the simulation-driven design and manufacturing solutions using Altair HyperWorks. So just I want to give a brief about what is a digital manufacturing. Orally, I'll give it. So digital manufacturing is application of your computer systems where you can manufacturing services and supply chains and products and process. So digital manufacturing technologies link to your systems and process across all areas of your production, okay, to create an integrated approach where you want to manufacturing from design to production and onto servicing of the final products as well. So from the scratch onwards, so what is digital manufacturing? So generally, is an application of computer systems. So using a computer systems, we are starting the design stage, designing with the help of napkin sketch or a 2D drawings. From that, you are getting into the 3D domain, and next you are getting into the physical prototype, and then you do the physical testing. Once the physical test is done, if it is passed, you are getting release this particular part into a manufacture, like multiple parts you are going to manufacture. That is what the complete life cycle of a design, digital design technology, I can say. And if design fails, so what you do in the physical test, if design fails, so what, as an engineer, what we do is we'll remodify it with adding some stiffener, or we are changing the, we may change the material. Okay, so these all system in system itself, we are developing it, and again you are going for the physical test setup. So this is a complete product life cycle management. Whatever the design stage is there, which is very important to any industry, because so many trial and errors, so much time is consuming at that particular location itself. So most of the industries are thinking to not to waste money on the physical test setup, or like whatever the manufacturing parts are there, without testing it. If they go for manufacturing, they'll get more loss in the industries, because as I said, a design study is very important. Once the design is perfectly done, then you can go for the additional prototypes. If design itself is failing, and again you are doing multiple manufacturing of that particular parts, definitely it will be a very big loss. So system simulations will be helpful to the engineers to come up with a good solution to the industries, okay, where it can reduce the material cost, it can reduce your time to the company, okay, where it will reduce the workers' time also who are spending on that manufacturing time, so that also it will come down. Yeah. So what a design engineer will do, so where he will do modeling, and like whatever the simulating process, it is possible to, once it
Sir,
is yeah, please tell me.
the slides are not moving, sir.
Yeah, I'm orally explaining about the digital manufacturing. Next, I'll get into the software, sir.
Carry on, carry on.
Yeah. So now, what exactly is simulating process? Whether it is possible to improve the quality of manufacturing and the decision making can be done? Yes, using a digital manufacturing technologies, like I'm going to show you all the manufacturing technologies which we have in Altair product portfolio. How it will be helpful to the industries where they can do a decision making very faster, and they can improve the product life cycle management process very fastly, where they can save cost saving be coming to the industry, they can reduce the time to the market, and they can create a joined up manufacturing process that unites a digital tools with the physical execution of the manufacturing industries. So actually there are three aspects of digital manufacturing, I can say. One is a product life cycle management. Next is a smart factory. They should have a smart machineries for doing all these digital transformations, which allows a greater visibility of the factory process, controlling systems, and optimization to improve the performance. So smart factory is very important. The good machinery should be there to do digital manufacturing. And other one is the third one is the value chain management, which focuses on reducing the resources to create an optimal process with the decreased inventories while doing a manufacturing. So these all like one is, as I said, three aspects of digital manufacturing. One is product life cycle management, where the engineering design before moving to the production, we are going to design the model and then we'll do the production, right? And next is smart factory. As I said, good machineries are required, digital machineries. So digital transformations will be very useful to reduce the manpower also in that industries. And value chain management, nothing but the chain management is required for marketing purpose. Whatever the product we have designed, that is very important. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about the Altair portfolio, how it helps digital technologies in design and manufacturing systems. So coming to simulation-driven design and manufacturing using manufacturing systems using Altair HyperWorks, the first topic I'm covering about is Inspire Inspire Studio. So this is a product. This is a product called Industrial Tool Design, we'll call it as, where most of our styling, aesthetic design engineers will use this particular product. So if you see the slide itself, you can see how complex in nature it is. The slides, what are the slides you are visualizing on the screen? So the image. So these are very complex in nature. So it needs a very good polynub or surface modeling tools are required where to capture these kind of complex kind of structures. So this is a very good tool. I can say very user-friendly tool. You can visualize this particular, the next slide, it talks about the complete Inspire Studio in 1 minute. So Inspire Studio is a tool, okay, which allows the designers to develop forms faster. It enables to capture all the initial sketch, I can say, from exploration of styling alternatives. So, which is a new software revolution, I can say, which enables designers, architects, and digital artists to create, evaluate, and visualize the design ideas faster than ever before. Because if you have an idea, okay, so the first image is a napkin sketch image, it's on the paper. So now from this, you want to get out of 3D model from this 2D sketch. So what we do is we'll get this particular image, JPG image, into the software, and using a curves, polynubs, we develop this particular model, and finally it will be, this is a production model it is. So whatever we designed, it's a nothing but a pen cover. Okay, it's an isogrid structure inside, and outer side is like a styling design. So it's a pen cover. So pen is placed inside. Okay, so this is what the aesthetics, by looking itself, they feel it's an eye-catchy product. So most of the sales will happen with the help of this eye-catchy product itself. So nowadays, the digital images can be bring into the softwares, and that images you can capture with the 3D polynubs, and you can go for the final printing model. So whatever you are seeing, it's a 3D printed model. It is additive manufacturing using a metal. They have did this particular model. So that's why the Alter Inspire Studio, which helps the design engineers, architects, and digital artists to create, evaluate, and visualization using like different ideas. You can define it, and where it also helps the engineers to visualize their products with realistic renderings as well. So it generates in real time, like it will show you a real time rendering image. So right side image, if you see, it's a real time images of your particular model. This tool is called All in One Industrial Design Solution. From the construction history, from the sketching onwards, if you take from the integrated sketchy, it's a parametric or non-parametric sketches. You can design it in Inspire Studio. And then you go for the construction history, where you have a model browser. Like whenever you want to edit the sketches, you can edit as same like other CAD tools. And then you can create a surfaces from that from the sketches, and curves and surfaces you can create. From that surfaces, you can create a polynubs to make it as a stylish solid parts. From that, you can render and animate it. Okay, rendering also I can do it. Rendering is nothing but the real, the photorealistic images. The realistic images it will show you with the lightening effect and the color effects. You can develop it in the same Inspire Studio. So I can say it's called stunning images and animations you can capture in the Inspire Studio tool. In a single environment, you can all this. You can do all this. Application like creating a sketching, creating a 2D curves, developing a 3D model, then rendering and animation, you can do it. It's very flexible tool. You can see the simple video here, how you can develop parametrically parametrical design, and how easily we can change the shape of the particular product, whatever the design you have did. So using a pull and push options, I can modify very easily the dimensions of that. So it's a very user interface, very user friendly. Powerful construction history will be there. Anytime you can go to that construction history, whichever the curvatures you want to edit, like it may be a circle, it may be edges, it may be a rectangle. So that directly you can edit on the screen itself, and you can modify the geometries. So this particular shoe has been developed with one of the company in Hyderabad. It's a there is one shoe manufacturing is available in Toli Choki. There is one government lab itself. So they are developing this particular shoe footwear for the sports sportsmen. So this particular tool is developed. So this particular tool is used by that particular company, and this is the design they are developing. And there is other company in Secunderabad itself. They are also working on the company name is called Lechel. That company is also using for this designing that particular shoes. They are into a shoes manufacturer. Again, they want aesthetic, like looking wise, it should be eye catchier. So they are designing the particular shoes in a digital way using a digital image. They first they draw it on a 2D paper, then that image will be bought into Inspire Studio, and they start with the curvatures and polynerves and solids they're using. And we have Boolean operations, a simple GUI window is available. Surface extractions is there. You can combine intersections, you can find out subtraction, uni. You can round it, nothing but fillets, you can capture it. You can create a pockets, you can create a surface offsets, you can extract the surfaces, you can combine the solids, and you can rebuild with the help of the points. So these are all options are available in Inspire Studio. And there are some a single icon is available where the multiple options you can switch it on. Those options itself you can use it. That is called tool belt. And this is a model browser in the interface. And this is the construction history of the company, construction history of the design, and the guided bar. So you can create a most complex freeform shapes with polygonal modeling, and retain technical precision with solid modeling, and generate smooth and continuous polynerves, curves, and surfaces. So in a parametric CAD software, it took around 120 minutes, but in Inspire Studio, within 15 minutes, you can develop this kind of parametric model with all construction history, what it has in the CAD software, the same thing it has in Inspire Studio. This makes updates and iterations very easily. We can do it. So rapid concept geometry design, you can create a complete upper body, include all important details. So as I said, bringing from the sketch, so this is a 2D sketch, export geometry as a mesh, and one day turnaround, it will take the time from this one to this one. And this particular mesh, you can export as a .fvm file where you can import into Hypermesh, and you can do the simulation or any other SOLIDWORKS also can do it, that meshing one. So you can see that start from the freehand sketch, how we are creating a 3D model. It's a 2 minutes video, very faster video it is. So he's creating a 2D plane and a 3D plane. Using a push and pull options itself, we are developing this particular 3D model. So how easily we can get the digital images, that digital images, how we can capture as a 3D modeling, you can see how simply we can create it with the help of points and edges. Simply you are using push and pull option. So these are called polynerves, nothing but a surfaces, A-class surfaces, you can use it. So this will reduce a lot of time to the design engineers where they want to develop the conceptual shapes. Okay, they can use this Inspire Studio as a tool. They can get the images and start working on the 3D model. And the photorealistic rendering as also you can do it. So this is the realistic image, I can say, the photorealistic image. So these are all rendering options which are available. So you can apply the material, you can apply the texture positioning, so how it will be. And you can also have a lightening effects. There are multiple material libraries are available where you can render that particular 3D model with a realistic scenarios, realistic color indications. You can do it. So it's very simple. So within 1 minute, 42 seconds, he has developed this particular complete 2D to 3D. And best photorealistic rendering, as I said. So take an advantage for a truly comprehensive rendering system, which is integrated all industry leading rendering techniques, I can say, and the most efficient memory management functions it has, unlimited output resolutions, as well as multi-threaded and multi-processor renderings, which makes Inspire Studio the perfect tool for generating a photorealistic images. So real-time rendering further improves interactivity during the review and visualization phase of a design and simulation. So if you do any drop test or if you do any crash analysis of a car, that complete animation you can bring into Inspire Studio, and you can do the animation with a photorealistic color rendering. You can do it for that, and you can simulate it. So it shows like a real car is hitting the particular rigid wall. So that kind of scenarios you can develop. So the particular bicycle on the screen also, it is from Francisco. This is a university who is using for bicycle design. So design is developed in Inspire Studio, and rendering with the lightening, you can see it has kept in a room. And right side, if you see the jewelry design, a jewelry design is also developed in Inspire Studio, and it has been rendered. And right side, the bottom one image is for lightweight chair structures with a conceptual idea. It's a new idea that the engineer has developed. Apart from that, the notable features in this particular tool is we have a construction history where the engineer can start working on the 2D drawings. I can say construction history is also available where you can modify the objects from past stages to past stages also, like old sketches also you can remove it, you can edit it. And you can also do sketching, 2D, 3D, 2D sketches are available, like curve, cylinder, circle, okay, curves, fillets, all these options are available in surface and curvatures. Polynovs is for solid modeling, and rendering and animation. So these are the notable features of this particular product, Inspire Studio. So I hope this particular tool is clear to everyone. So this is about
Inspire Studio.
Yeah, please. Hello.
Yeah. So actually this kind of design can also be done in Blender as well, right?
Which one?
This kind of the design what you have did in that polynovs concept.
Correct. In which you are asking? In which?
In Blender, I think also we can design the same thing. Like we will be keeping our image in that, and then we will be doing the extrusion and then other process. The same kind of what you are doing here.
Blender.
Yeah. Blender. Yes, I'm saying Blender.
Blender. Okay.
So, yeah. In that case, what is the difference which you can provide in that this Inspire Studio?
So I told some of the notable features of this particular product. So it has a very fine tune. A single environment window is one thing. In the single environment window itself, most of the features are available, and you have a direct import of CAD softwares like CATIA, ProE, SolidWorks, IGS. Okay, ideas file. .dwg files you can import. So we are competing with other softwares. So we are very very flexible in CAD formats. So directly you can import. There is no translators are required. We support all IGS, STEP, Parasolid, ProE, Point Cloud also. If you have a point data, you can import that. At the same time, you can export to IGS, Parasolid, STL file. When you want to do additive manufacturing, you can also do save it as a STL file, VDFS, VRML files, that all you can do it with the help of Inspire Studio. And as I said, photorealistic capturing, you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
The rendering. So this is an advantage if I can say compared to other softwares.
Okay. what about this parametric? Can we do it with this interface today itself, or like we need to shift it to other software?
Not required. Actually, previously in Inspire Studio, it was not there. In the latest version, it is there now. The parametric modeling, you can do it.
Okay, fine.
Yeah. And this software is available with Windows and Mac. Like a normal machine also, you can use it. And for rendering, actually, we need a graphics card. High-end graphics card is there, like 2 GB graphics card or 4 GB graphics card is required. Because whenever you are saying rendering, a rendering needs high graphics. It may be any software. So this is about the Inspire Studio, where you can any design engineer, artist. Inspire Studio is using by IIT Hyderabad as well. What IIT Hyderabad is doing is they are creating some animations. What I can say, they are capturing some of the seven tombs. They are visiting seven tombs, Golconda fort. Okay, they are creating some stories like about the kings, what exactly they did. So all these particular designs, they are using this Inspire Studio. They are capturing that human, like the structure images, and the structures are designed in this Inspire Studio, and they are creating a storyline of that. It's a short movie kind of thing. They are developing it. They are using some other tools for that, making a movie. For animations and everything, but designing whatever the structures are there, they are using Inspire Studio for that, from the photos to realistic 3D model. So there are some pre-recorded videos. Just I want to show you how user-friendly it is. So there is a snapping points are available, like using a push and pull options. From 2D to 3D, you can generate it, and you can parameterize. And apart from parametric design, you can also do manufacturing drawings with the help of Inspire Studio. I don't know about the Blender, but in Inspire Studio, you can do manufacturing drawings as well. So using a point data also, you can get your point data. It may be a gear design. It may be any complex, complex in nature shapes. You can get that point data into this, and you can start creating the polynurbs like this using the help of surfaces. So this is again a material application and rendering. So you can add a thickness for that, and you can add a fillets for that. You have a chamfer option. You can add a global thickness for that particular part. So with some thickness, uniform thickness, distributed thickness also, you can assign it for these particular designs. Variable thickness, I can say. You can see these all are about parametric design. So you can use Boolean operations for adding. So just pull and push. So you can change the fillet radius as well. So this is about the 3D model developed in Inspire Studio. Constraint-based technical like sketching, where you can fix some of the parts and so it should not move. That sketch should not go in global location, right? So it should fix it in that local area. So that is what is a constraint-based sketching will call us. So which is there in other CAD softwares like CATIA, PROE, SOLIDWORKS. There is a fixed and constraint is there. You can give constraint for that particular design. You can modify the dimensions anytime, same like a CATIA or PROE software. And you can start working on that. And you can also give parametric relationship to the existing CAD geometry. That also you can create it. Simply he's projecting it. He's projecting to the particular surface, chair surface. This is how it has been placed. Modeling of mechanical part, starting from 2D sketch. You can model very freely here, creating by designers like Inspire Studio provides freeform surfaces, solid modeling, and polygonal modeling in a single package itself, which allows the best approach to be applied to each aspect of designs. Where design engineers can decide themselves. And it also allows user to mix and match modeling techniques on the fly without any additional plugins. Okay. And you can make changes very effortlessly using this Inspire Studio. The construction tree history allows user to edit a point or a parameter and then let Inspire automatically update the entire model, whatever you're seeing on the screen. Typically is like surface modelers requires the recreation of an entire model where you can accommodate a dimensional change. Also, you can do it. So you're using a spline kind of option here, sweep surface. With shelling thickness. And you can also use the reverse engineering purpose also. This particular tool will be helpful where you can get the point data, as I said, where on that points you can create a surfaces using like, for example, point cloud. Okay, so that point cloud will be generate points on the 3D model, the realistic real 3D model. That points you can get into Inspire Studio and you can do reverse engineering design, I can say. So fillet, you're applying on that and so you're adding a chamfer over here. You can modify any dimension anytime. So by which automatic updates will happen in the 3D geometry itself. All the entities are parametric in this model. So that's why when I change one parametric model, the whole cylindrical holes are also updated and this particular 3D model is also updated. You can see that you can increase the dimension on the 3D model itself. And polynups, using a styling. So these all already have shown this particular thing. I'll skip this particular video because we have already covered. And photorealistic rendering, how we can do it for the 3D model. You can see it's a kitchen modeler, kitchen model it is. Easy to use interactive rendering tool, which we have used this material library. You can select this material library from which you are going to select the complete assembly and aluminum. We are applying for that and matte finish, matte black plastic we are saying, so that so you can select depends on your requirement and you can assign to that particular 3D model. Once that is done, you can keep it in the realistic scenarios in where you want to place, whether it is a room or a platform or a wooden table, that you can select from that environment window. And once it is done, a lightening effect. So where you want to paste a light. So when you give here, the lighting shadow will be appeared on the other side. So this is how the photorealistic kind of images can be captured, and that images you can keep it as a bookmark. And you can also apply visual effects like glare, pigmenting. Okay, you can see that shining kind of thing. So these kind of options are available, and then you can finally save that. Dark room kind of thing, you can create it. So evaluate different options and get the best image out of that. Some of the images which were designed using Inspire Studio, it may be a jewelry, shoe manufacturer, okay. Furnitures. Interior design. All are designed in Inspire Studio and rendered in the Inspire Studio itself. Home goods. Automotive images. This is what we have shown in the design video. Sports. So that is about the Inspire Studio. So coming to Altair HyperWorks, we have many other modules. Okay. Coming to Altair HyperWorks, HyperWorks as a big portfolio, I can say. There are many, many modules which are using by the industries. I can say HyperWorks is into, HyperWorks is a industry broadcast integrated simulation software suite where user can model they can use a hyper mesh for model building where they can develop the complete car as a finite element model using hyper mesh, a complete truck, or it may be any kind of complex geometries in nature. Hyper mesh, as you know, it's a popular for finite element modeling itself. So most of the industries also, and the job opportunities for the students, if you see, hyper mesh jobs are very high compared to any other solvers. Okay, so if you see the industries, hyper mesh users will be higher, solver users will be very less. Okay, so most of the in the CAE process, most of the hyper mesh, okay, hyper mesh will consider around 75% of the work in an industry. The remaining 15% will be on the solving, another 10 to 15% will be on the post processing. So that's why pre processing is very important in all the industries. That's why they use a prerequisite software called hyper mesh for them, where they can simulate a multiple analysis, like whatever the experience you have seen, my static, normal mode, buckling, inertia relief analysis, forced vibration like shock, harmonic, random response, fatigue life. Okay, all these scenarios will come later on. First is meshing. So without meshing, you can't continue the stress related detailed stress analysis, detailed FE analysis you cannot carry out. So for that purpose, in HyperWorks, the main flagship product is called HyperMesh. In HyperMesh, not only you can do structured mesh, you can do unstructured mesh as well. And composite mesh is interested by any user or any faculty. Okay, they can get the composite modeling here itself, number of layers, orientations, and the composite materials. You can assign it. You can do bird impact analysis, any stone impact analysis, or impact on a glass, underwater blast, underground blast, drop test of any containers, including fluid, I can say, fluid structure interaction problems, torpedo launching in the sea. All these simulations you can carry out in HyperWorks using a RADIOS. OptiStruct is a solver where you can do implicit analysis like geometric nonlinearity, material nonlinearity. Just a minute, Venkat Narayan says. Hello, sir. Yeah. So next, we are talking about the solid thinking. Solid thinking, again, it's related to digital design and manufacturing systems. And product design is nothing but as I said, we are into product design as well. Where we took projects from the industries we take projects from the industries and we deliver with innovation to our clients. So coming to the Inspire, when you're talking about the Inspire structures, so topology optimization is very good technique in the industries. So why this topology optimization has been introduced in 1992 itself? So using Altair HyperWorks has been introduced this technique in 1992 itself. As we started with academic research and then early version of OptiStruct in 1992 to 96, we have done some research and then implemented in Altair HyperWorks in the version of OptiStruct solver itself. Early applications and early adopters after we released into the market. So firstly, we have released as a commercial version of OptiStruct. Then most of the expertise usage of this particular topology optimization has been grown in industries, and they were accepted whatever the result it has been giving. Okay, you understand, in the next slides, you'll understand what is topology optimization, but how it has started the journey, I'm explaining here. And once the industry is accepted, then we have accelerated our product development portfolio with our technical strength people, which are available in Altair India in Bangalore location. So we have developed the optimization tool in a very faster way. And we have come up with a very multiple techniques, where it may be called as a weight reduction technique or thickness reduction technique or composite technique, composite optimization technique, or it may be a shape optimization or size optimization technique. All this has been developed from 2005 onwards, and we have released later on in the next versions. So that is what our the complete topology optimization journey and how we have developed the optimization. So he is a James Kappa. He's an Altair CEO, sits in USA Detroit. And this software offers up to a most efficient design possible based on the massive amount of data, often creating a shapes human engineers would be unlikely to imagine how exactly the shapes looks like once it does topology optimization. So you're going to see that kind of images in Inspire. So we come up with Inspire structures, which is focused on design engineers, especially directly working on the CAD model itself. So that is what solid thinking Inspire will call as. Now it is named as Altair Inspire Structure. It is called Inspire, I can say Inspire Structure, optimization driven design. So any engineer, any CAD engineer, how he design a model starting from the napkin sketch, and he will start a detailed design. Then he went for the final product, portfolio, final product. Once the product is ready, they'll go for physical prototype. Once the physical prototype is ready, then it will go for physical test setup. Physical test setup is passed, then it's good. But if it is not passing at all in the physical test setup, it may be a buckling test, it may be a vibration test, it may be a shock test, okay? It may be a random test, or it may be a fatigue life test. It may be a test coupon test of the material. So if it is failing, what design engineer will do? He will come up to again detail designing. He will modify the designing with adding a stiffener or removing the stiffener and adding a stiffener at another location where exactly it is failing. We may also change the material and check the studies, right? So these all iterations we do. It may go up to 10 or 15 iterations, right? Then we'll get a final product which is going to pass. So it is taking a lot of time to the industry to come up with a final product, right? So that is where Inspire structure will help you. This solid thinking Inspire will help you to come up with a good design upfront to the CAD engineer. No need of many iterations. Whatever the trial and error iteration has been did by the CAD engineer, that has been reduced. So this origin of topology optimization has come up with a doctor, Julius Wolf, is a engineer who in 19th century, he's an orthopedic surgeon. So what he was mentioning is, as a consequence of primary shape variations, okay, and continuous loading, or even due to loading alone, bone changes its inner architecture according to the mathematical rules. So what he's telling is, whenever the continuous loading is happening, the primary shape variations will be happening in the bone as well. The inner architecture, according to the mathematical rules, and as a secondary effect, so which was same as mathematical rules, it also changes the shape internally. The bones has been changing the shape. Depends on your heavy weight. Okay, if you come down, the bone shape will be changing. If your weight is high, the bone shape will be changed. So it depends on that study. Julius Wolf, doctor, has been come up with the mathematical rules. Okay, he has told that this particular is happening in our human nature itself. So the same similar kind of optimization can be using a mathematical rules. We can also develop a better result, better CAD model before going to the original manufacturing. A better CAD model, which is structurally stiffened part, can be come up with the mathematical equations. So this forms the basis for Altair's topology optimization technique. I mean, it's a base of that. And any traditional design tools, okay, there is a challenge. Like engineer has a large product knowledge, but it takes a lot of time, detailed design he has to do, design validation he has to do, and okay, just a minute. Lakshmi, I'm in training demo. Lakshmi, tell me.
Oh, what time did you complete? Yeah?
12 p.m.
Okay. One query was there on Atmesh. So what shall I do? Can I align this one? Will you be able to do?
Yeah, yeah. Karthik, yes, is there. You can align him. I'll call you after 12, yeah. Sorry for the inconvenience. My manager has called. The challenge in traditional design is engineer has a very good product knowledge, but he has to follow some of the the regular procedure, like detailed designing, and then he will go for the validation. Once the validation is done, again they will come back with the modifications. It is very difficult to the CAD engineer. When he starts from the concept, detailed designing, validation, okay, it takes a lot of time to come up with a final product. But again, they'll remodifications will come by the CA engineers, or it may be a manufacturing people. It will come back to us and they'll tell to modify it. So these are all again, it is a time taking process in a traditional way. Concept design is so most of the company will spend a lot of money on the conceptual design itself. Okay, it will take a lot of time at the concept design itself. So we have a design freedom at the starting stage, because they'll give a lot of time frame to us to come up with a very good design, which should sustain all the mechanical or operating loading conditions. So that is what the industry will look at. But as a design engineer, we develop the product, but somehow it is failing in the next iterations, CA iteration, or it may be a manufacturing iterations. That is where Inspire, Altair Inspire structure will help design engineers come up with a good conceptual design optimization shapes, where it will reduce all the design iterations, what design engineers spending a lot of time on that. So this particular tool will help you, will help the design engineer to come up with a good idea, and he can this will give an idea how would be the shape of the particular structure for the operating loading conditions. From that shape, the user can design in a conventional way and they can go for the manufacturing. Okay, in Inspire structure itself, once the optimization is done, okay, immediately you can do the structural analysis, and you can simulate here itself, and you can compare the baseline and the modified optimized model as well. So both the simulations you can carry out in the here itself. So coming to optimization driven design, so generally when you go for original traditional approach, CAD, once the CAD is done, detailed designing, you're going for that. After defeaturing, you're going for the CAE results are done. If it is satisfied, again, you're coming to the CAD. Again, you're going for the final manufacturing, that particular part you're going to the giving to the manufacturer. So it is very too late in traditional way. Coming to the Inspire structure optimization driven design technique. So at the starting stage itself, you can come up with, there is two approaches in this, in the Inspire itself. You can start from idea, or you can take the existing part from last 10 years or 20 years, industry is using that particular part you can consider, and you can come up with an idea, like Inspire structure will give an idea to you, how would be the design for that particular applied loading conditions, it will suggest you. Okay, so once it is suggested, directly you're going to simulate that one, and you're checking itself. No need of giving to the CA engineer. Directly you can run the simulation and you can check the results, and you can give it to your manager saying that this is the part was baseline part, and this is the optimized part. These are the results for the baseline as well as the structured optimized part. So that is where it will reduce your time. Like once it is reduce the time, the industries also are required in the same way. Design performance should meet your structural performance, and the maturity, whatever it is giving the design, okay, optimization design, it is structurally efficient part it is giving, okay, and it's a mathematical calculation it is giving at the background, it is doing at the background, it is giving a results to us. How to create optimized concepts using Inspire structure? Okay, so a simple video, it's a 2 minutes introduction video of Solid Thinking Inspire. You can see this video, you'll understand what exactly the topology optimization is. Previous projects. So you are getting first time light in weight structure, and which meets your structural performance as well. So what is Solid Thinking Inspire? It's an old name, but now it is Inspire will call us. What is Solid Thinking Inspire? Solid Thinking Inspire is helpful for design engineers. It is developed for design engineers, product engineers, and architects, where they can create and investigate on the structural efficient concepts quickly and easily with the help of Inspire tool. If you see the right side image, we have considered the complete solid part as a design space. Wherever the cylindrical area is there, that is in gray color. You can see my mouse arrow. So this is a gray color. That is my non-design space. So this is a fixing condition, and the loads are applied on this particular flat face. And this particular flat face depends on your loading condition. The software is suggesting you to add the stiffeners. to add the stiffeners at the required location area. Okay, so generally what it does, whatever the result it is giving a mathematical correct answer upfront to the design engineer, where for that particular operating loading condition, the design engineer has to add the stiffeners in this way. Okay, so from this, design engineer has to start his own design, where he has to apply pockets, where he has to keep the pockets, he has to understand, and he need to start his own design. So using Inspire, the design engineer will get a faster, smarter, and lighter in weight structures using Inspire tool. How does Inspire will work? Inspire requires a packaging space is required, nothing but a design packaging space, and where you can apply the loading conditions. Once the loading conditions are applied on the design problem, okay, Inspire quickly generates an ideal shape and gives the results to you as a yellow color, uneven surface load, whatever it is showing. So this is what it will give. From that, Inspire has a polynups where you can use a fit polynups option, that whatever the uneven shape it is giving, that solids will become as a smooth solids directly as you're visualizing it. And once it is fitted as a polynub, it's a manufacturing part that immediately you can do the simulation. The simulation results you are seeing now, these are the simulation result where you can check the stresses and deformations, factor of safety, compression, tension, okay, major principal stresses, maximum principal stresses, that all visualizations you can do it in the same single environment window. So using Inspire structural solutions, typically the results will be in lighter in weight, and it helps the design engineers to eliminate the structural design problems which will have in the design iterations. Okay, so no need of doing multiple iterations. So in the starting stage itself, for the concept engineers or digital design engineers or product engineers, this particular tool will give an idea. Okay, so what exactly it does, wherever the high loads are there, wherever the load path is there, it will add the material. Wherever the load path is not there, it will remove the material. So it generally chips away the material wherever it is not required. It adds the material wherever it required. So that is what it is doing at the background. And this is what the optimized structures it gives. This technique is called topology optimization. And if you see the traditional design way, design procedure, developed from the concept, detailed designing has to be done, validation and prototype. Once the validation fails, again you should come to detailed design. It will, so you doesn't know how many iterations it will go for, but once the detailed design is done, once the validation is done, you are going for the documentation and production. But coming to Inspire design process upfront, it is reducing a lot of time to the industries. Upfront, it is giving a mathematically correct answer with optimized shape. That optimized shape you are going to design, and you are validating it, because in the single environment window itself, once the optimization is done, immediately you are validating structurally, and you are telling to the manager saying that, or in the industry you are saying that this is what the structural looks like, optimized structure looks like. This is a strengthened part and a stiffened part compared to your operating loading condition and baseline product. So this is the final prototype it looks like, and which will meet your design requirement. And here what you are doing in Inspire, starting with the solution, it gives a solution at the upfront, and by which a design engineer will be starting a final prototype, and then they'll go for the production. So which using an Inspire design process, the industries are getting a time they are reducing the time to release into the market whatever the products are designed. Benefits of Inspire upfront: concept design and simulation you can carry out. The right side image is a door hinge of aeroplane. Previously it was solidly filled with a blue color area. You can see that is called design space. Gray area is my non-design space, and the optimization topology optimization we carried out, it generates and simulates structurally efficient concepts for that particular door hinge. So this is a design space and non-design space. Now you can see the optimized result, how it has been created. Okay, and it is very easy to learn software. It generates concepts in minutes. It solves challenging design problems very easily, and it talks to all other CAD softwares as Inspire Studio. Same like Inspire Studio, it can talk to all other CAD softwares. Where any CAD engineer can use this particular tool. That is why we have implemented this one. It is also doing a simulation. As I said, structural static analysis, bolt prediction analysis, buckling analysis you can carry out. Normal mode analysis also you can carry out. While doing the simulation itself, you can maximize your frequencies for the particular parts. So there are some objective functions are available in the optimization techniques. Who all are using Inspire? The main users of this particular Inspire structure is Boeing, Airbus, Land Rover, Jaguar, Ford, Chrysler, all the automotive industries and aerospace industries are using this particular particular tool. Whoever is interested mainly to reduce the weight in the particular existing parts, they can use Inspire structure as a tool. Full assembly redesigning with Inspire. So in this particular assembly, the bottom structure and this arm and this existing robot design, the robot holder design, I want to modify it. So this I have filled with a solid part because I don't know how to model it in a different way. So as a design engineer, I know the locations of mountings and I know the design of how much volume it covers. So that I have designed it. So this is a final part output using Inspire structures optimization result. 30% weight reduction is achieved. What are the robotic arms were there? So previously I shown this kind of video. This is the video which I shown. And I told in two ways you can do it. Design from scratch, improve the existing designs. So design from scratch is nothing but you make a complete solid. And from that you can expect a optimization result. Or you can take 20 years or 10 years from onwards, industry is using the existing parts. That also you can consider for the optimization technique and you can improve your designs. So this video will showcase from the conceptual shape, how it has been optimized. Design space I have considered, the maroon color is design space from which topology optimization has given a result. These are the loading condition and these are the contacts we have used. These are the material removal condition, manufacturing constraints we have used. And for this also, what I did is I have removed some of the pockets. You see that very simply I can remove it. Just click on that, it will remove. Why I'm removing? That was designed by a design engineer, right? Removing the pockets and making as a lightweight. But I'm removing all these things and fillets, pockets, and I'm removing it and making as a complete solid. That is my first step in my optimization. The next is after designing space is assigned, I'll do optimization. I'll get this optimization result. You see this? So that is what topology optimization result. Same way for the existing part, this is the optimization result. So you are generating a concepts from Inspire structure tool. Once that is done, you can do the polynerves. You can use the polynerves option or directly you can do the simulation where you can see the displacement, yield stress, factor of safety, compression and tension, maximum shear strain, maximum principal stresses, all in a single environment window itself. So by which you'll understand, okay, still I can fine tune somewhere else in the optimization result as well. Okay, that option is available. You can also have a compare results. When you click this compare results, the baseline model and the optimized model results can be compared. What is the stress for the baseline? What is the stress for the optimized part? What is the displacement of that baseline model? What is the stress for the optimized model? So that you can see the tabular form in an easy way. And you can prepare for the part for manufacturing using a polynerves option. So using a polynerves, any user, any CAD engineer can develop very easily. You can take the symmetric cut of that and you can create a using the polynerves, you can wrap it up like this, select plane to plane, it will create it. So wherever it is intersecting, so finally you can do Boolean operations in this. So I'll forward it so you can see that. Once the design is done, you can use Boolean operations and this is the final part we achieved using a Boolean operations. And this is a final rendered part. So for casting, you can use this particular product. Export Inspire results back into the CAD model. And this is a Inspire Studio, nothing but Inspire Studio. You can export it and you can modify it in a very smoother way. And this is the final product of that. So finally, 30% of weight reduction you can achieve. And bold pretension analysis also can carry out. Any user is interested. You can see this particular video. It explains about the complete setup of bold pretension of the assembly for the assembly. You can have a contacts. Automatic fasteners are there. Wherever the cylindrical holes are there, you can create that, select that holes. Nut and bolt option is available. Screws are there. Ground nut is option is there. You can select it. You can apply the enable option. You can apply the pretension over there. Click on that fastener part and say enable option. Enter 100 newtons or 10 newtons over there. Depends on your requirement. After simulation, you can play the animation. You can see that. And you can see the reaction forces as well, wherever the bolts are holded. So if you take an assembly, contacts are very important. So when I click on contacts, it is saying 8 in a bracket. That means in eight places, the surfaces are mating. So I have given a bonded contact. And wherever the holes are there, I'm using fasteners. I'm taking screws as a fastener, fasten that holes. So just simply you can, it will understand the diameters and everything. Automatically it will assign it. Once the boundary conditions are assigned, materials are assigned. Okay. There is a material library inside. You can assign for that pretension and this is a material library, materials. You can see the results in the single environment window after analyzing. After this analyzation, you can also do optimization. And you can see that the contacts, how it is working. So it uses a background tetrahedral second order elements it will use. That's why you'll get more accurate results. So user can also do topography optimization on sheet metal and plastic parts. Once you import the sheet metal part, you are going to generate a mid surface. You can create a bolts wherever the holes are there. And you can apply the material for that. Once the material is done, you are selecting the design space with the right click. Okay. And what are the bead patterns you want, whether it is linear bead pattern or circular pattern that user has to select. So it's a cylindrical circular, I'll use it. So circular, I'll select that particular face. And then I'll go for manufacturing constraints. In what way the stamping should be done. So here, user has to give bead topography you need to select. There, he has to enter bead width, draw angle, and height of the bead. Once you do the simulation, it will give a bead pattern to you. Without adding any mass, it will give a stiffened part to you. You see that. Circular bead patterns. It is suggesting you to add a bead pattern in that region to strengthen this particular part. So it is increasing stiffness of the part here. Natural frequency will be increased compared to the baseline model and the new model. So this is another technique called topography optimization, bead patterns. So this is an example of oil pan example. So design engineer has been developed these particular bead patterns. Okay. And this is the height thickness of that particular part. The first mode is 1041 Hertz for the baseline model. Okay. And now we want to maximize the stiffness without adding any mass. And we want to, the objective is, objective of this particular optimization is topography optimization. I want to maximize the frequency of the particular baseline model. So 1041 Hertz is my baseline design. Now, after doing my optimization, sheet metal topography optimization, it has given me the bead patterns. For that bead patterns, I have considered many iterations here with the different manufacturing constraints. You can see that the first frequency is increasing here for this particular bead pattern. I have applied separate boundary conditions. So same boundary conditions, but manufacturing constraints, I have used different one. So for the different option, I got a very good result. Finally, we are considering this particular part because I got 1155 hertz as my first frequency. So these are the concepts generated by the Inspire tool for the sheet metal parts. So 360 grams is my weight here. 433 grams is the original model. So this is what the final design. 20% lighter in nature and stiffer in nature. This is what user can achieve with the help of Inspire structures tool. What we are doing, we are doing import the existing CAD model. We are doing the analysis. Once you're done, you are doing it's a workflow of Inspire. Once you do the optimization, again, you are designing it. And then you're going for the detailed design and you're checking the results of that as well. Okay. The next technique is called gauge optimization. Gauge optimization is nothing but a thickness optimization. For each sheet metal, wherever the sheets are available, for each sheet, what would be the thickness? It will suggest you upfront before going to the manufacturing. So generally, as a design engineer, will give some thickness and will give it. A CA engineer will give different thickness and he will do the many iterations. And he will suggest this thickness you have to use in this particular sheet, this thickness you have to use in different thickness because of the stresses are high in this region. So these are modifications will come up with a CA engineer. So to avoid that one, the CAD engineer itself, he can only run that particular thickness optimization and he can design in a proper way, which will not fail in CA results. So directly he can do gauge optimization. So please observe this video, watch this video. So we are doing a thickness optimization, nothing but gauge. It is called as where a user has to enter minimum and maximum values, means initial value is 3 mm. User has to enter 1 mm to 5 mm, you can vary. So what is optimization? Optimization does many iterations at the background, which is not visible to us. You can use it, you can see in output file, but it will not visible to us. Directly you can, what it does at the background is, whether it may be a topology or a topography or a size, it does many iterations. Around 30 iterations it will do. Topology, for example, first to 30 iterations, 30th iteration is my final design. So up to 30 iteration, what it does, in first iteration, it will remove some material and it will move it to some other location. It has not passed. Second iteration, it will move some material, it moved to some other location. It has not passed. Like that, it will do many iteration and finally it will say that 30th iteration is the final one. In the similar way, topography also, in first iteration, it will add 1 mm thickness, 1.1 thickness, 2 mm thickness, 2.1 mm thickness for the sheets. It will study many iterations. Once it is finalized, okay, at the last iteration, it will give a final result to you. Similar way, topography optimization, it also do many iterations. You are giving bead width, height and angle, right? It will vary. It will directly not apply that height, width and angle. It will vary with different angle. 0 to 2.1 mm height you are given, 2.1 mm height you have given. 0 to 2.1 mm, it will do many iterations. It will suggest you this is a particular bead at the last iteration. So that is why optimization result is not giving in a single shot. It is doing at the background many iterations, which is not visible to us, but it is giving a final result in the last iteration. What static analysis, what structural analysis you can carry out in the present version is linear static model, buckling, automatic joint creations, temperature analysis. You can do callouts. Callouts is nothing but maximum and minimum locations in the results, results comparison, reaction forces at bolts and nuts, screws, force, torque, angular velocity you can apply, ground fasteners, bolt pretensions also you can carry out. Apart from that, the additional capability of this particular tool is while doing kinematic simulation also, user can also do kinematic simulation. It may be a piston connecting rod, crankshaft, a complete simulation you can carry out, a kinematic simulation. From that, you can extract the forces. So this is an example video which covers a complete kinematic simulation. You can see how easily we can develop the kinematics. So where you'll get output of loads, extraction of the loads at the joint locations. So you can see how complex assemblies are it is. And it's very user friendly. Directly you can bring these kind of systems into Inspire and apply the joints. Automatically joints will be applied and you can do the motion analysis. Once you do the motion analysis, you'll get the output of torque forces as an output. That results you can apply immediately for the structural analysis and you can check it. You can see now I want to optimize that particular design space, the maroon color area, in the kinematic condition itself. So I am using topology optimization. Topology optimization we are carrying out for that particular design area. So how complex assemblies we can kinematic simulations you can carry out, you can see it. Within this kinematic system itself, you can also do optimization. So this is what the optimization part in kinematics. Due to that joint forces, it also does topology optimization. It gives results to us. You have actuators, sensors in this Inspire Motion. You can see wherever the joints are there, you can extract the forces. Right click on that, it will show the plot. And again, right click, you can export as an Excel sheet as well. It will export. You can see that export the plot option is available at the bottom side. You can export torque, displacement, angular displacement, all you can extract it from these particular results. Coil spring diameter also you can change anytime. Once the results are not coming properly, you can change anytime the diameter of the spring. You have this simple GUI. You can see that motor, actuator, spring option, gravity load analysis, motion analysis you can carry out. This is the actuator we have added. So in the geometry, you can design a simple models. Push and pull options are available, move the face option, mirror option, scaling option, Boolean operations. You can cut the solids into multiple pieces. You can simplify, like remove the pockets, remove the fillets. That option is available. You can partition it for design space and non-design space. For sheet metal, we have a mid-surface. These are solutions, nothing but fasteners, joints, connections, contacts, force, torque, pressure, constraint displacement, and enforced displacement, G loads, angular velocity, gravity load, temperature load, material library, mass application, manufacturing constraints for the topology optimization, topography optimization is bead. So these are all options in a single environment. If you go to geometry, geometry options. If you go to structures, you have a structure options. If you go for motion, kinematic simulations. There are additional, like Inspire manufacturing is also there. We are going to cover in the next slides. So you can add a mass, as I said, and you can connect with the surfaces and you can move it whichever the location required. So that much simple it is. So next one is Inspire casting. Casting is one like another part in Inspire where you can carry out, any engineer can carry out a casting process using a click-to-click Inspire casting simulation software, which allows the user to enhance and optimize their manufacturing components. Okay, where once you do the casting simulation, the one-click quick casting assessment is this. When you do the casting simulation using Inspire Cast, user will understand where does the porosity, solidification, temperature check, all this you can check it up in a single cut simulation. And this is the first cut simulation. If you want to do a detailed casting simulation, that also is possible in Inspire casting simulation itself. Now we have developed in a lot of, in a very good way. So this is about the solidification, temperature distribution, section view you can see. Whether solid is filling in a proper way or not while doing casting manufacturing, that you can check it up. Any air gaps are there inside the material filling, that all you can check it up in Inspire casting simulation tool. Apart from that, you can also add risers, chillers, depends on the result what you got. So before going to the original manufacturing of casting, here itself you are checking, like as I said, digital manufacturing means what? Before going to the original conventional manufacturing method, we are using some system simulation manufacturing tools where you are finding out the best result here itself. No need of multiple model manufacturing is required. Once you do the first cut simulation, once you satisfy, yes, my casting is doing properly here, there is no defects in my this model, then I'll go forward to the next level of product lifecycle management. Okay, so that is what is next is manufacturing. Inspire stamping, again, it's for sheet metal stamping. This is another good simulation tool, I can say, for sheet metal manufacturers. Any engineer, like design engineer, who is interested in sheet metal manufacturing, they can use this Inspire stamping tool. Vasavi Engineering College, Ibrahim Bagh, Hyderabad, is using this particular tool for their research. And the PhD scholars are using this particular tool. And recently, last week, they have published one paper using our tool itself on the stamping simulation. So once you do the forming, okay, what exactly you'll get as an output is, one is any wrinkles are forming while it is stamping, any thinning percentage is very less or high. Where is high location? A thinning percentage is where is high and where is less, that you can understand from these particular simulations. And blank estimation, like multiple sheets you want to manufacture in a single cut, right? So it is very difficult to understand to the user in a single, some area will be there. Within that area, how many blank sheets will be sitting, that to estimate, it is very difficult to the manufacturing engineer. So using that, using Inspire form, a blank shape estimation also, he can do it. Within a single sheet, how many type of prototypes can be manufactured, that you can estimate with the help of Inspire stamping. These are the single slides. In the next coming slides, we'll talk about the complete portfolio, some of the case studies of using Inspire structures. Amazon is one company. They are into agricultural manufacturing unit, agricultural equipment manufacturers. So these are the using Inspire without any manufacturing constraint. I got some additive manufactured part. With some manufacturing constraint like symmetric boundary condition, I used symmetric manufacturing constraint. I got symmetric structure. These are original manufacturing. These are original conventional method model it is. So what we got once the optimization is done, okay? They got specific structure of the casting part. Durability has been increased using Inspire. The factor of safety, 2.5 times the factor of safety is high compared to the baseline model. And while the weight was reduced by 8% from the original design, that is why they have benefited using Inspire structure. There's a one case study of Amazon. And the challenge is redesign of originally welded suspension component as a casting part while improving the weight and durability properties. The solution is Inspire structure they used. They have done some kinematic loading conditions also. And as I said, they have increased the durability factor by 2.5, 8% weight reduction, lower production cost. Production cost also has been reduced. High flexibility for customers in add-on modules like Inspire structures. This is optimized tool. So other bracket, this is a final tool. We are simulating it. So this is called a disc harrow bionic rocker arm weld construction, 16 meters of welds. Optimized cassette part is 35% cost reduction, 10% weight reduction, and 250% fatigue performance. Life is also increasing when you are doing this optimization. Casted part with a 3D printed form. So this is a 3D printer because it is conventionally, it is not possible. 11% weight reduction and 75% lead time reduction in the 3D printed part. And AAM is another customer in automotive industry. They develop differential gearboxes. Okay. So redesigning for the existing parts, they consider the existing part and they have done the optimization of that. So topology optimization has been carried out and it has suggested some of the stiffeners wherever it is required. The baseline was not there. It has removed that, it has added some stiffeners and it is suggested to add it. Okay, so weight has been reduced with 20% of mass and they got lighter in weight and the model is having a high strength compared to the baseline design. Scania is another automobile industry company. They have done some knuckle, steering knuckle part. Okay, so this is the original part from which we have developed a solid part using Inspire. Simplified tool, removing all the pockets, removing the fillets, and making as a complete solid. We have applied operating loading conditions. This is my design space, the maroon color, And once we do the optimization, so this is what the mounting structure it has given to us. Okay. So using a simulation driven design technique using Inspire structure, they got a very good structural performance model, which is having a 30% of mass reduction compared to the baseline model. And the development time has been increased compared to this the original model. Labor group, again, it's a very good case study, I can say, because this is the original mounting structure, the black color part, so which is located here. Okay. And there are some, it's a three axles will be there for this particular vehicle. It's a complete big truck. Three axles means around six mounting structures will be located for that particular assembly, larger assemblies. So if it is an eight wheel, you can say 16 mounting structures will be there. So if I reduce one weight of this particular part, automatically a lot of mass savings will be happen in the larger assemblies, correct? So this is the original part. So we have applied the boundary conditions. This is the optimized part it has shown to us. From this, the conventional design engineer has developed this one, and this is manufactured, and this is assembled here. It's a casted part. 50% mass has been reduced, and strength wise, it is high compared to the baseline model. So we got a strengthened part as well as a lightweight part using Inspire structures. Polaris is another company who has it into automotive industry and snow vehicle industries, their development. And for the pedal, we use this particular pedal and other structures. We use Inspire structure as an optimization tool. We consider the design space and non-design space, and then we optimized it. So this is what the optimized structure it has given. 35 to 40% of weight reduction is achieved from the existing design. So that is what they have achieved, and they have got a very good results in structural performance as well. So this is an example of Polaris. Race Face is another company into automotive industry. So they are into forging using this Inspire structure. They got a very good forging optimization result using a manufacturing constraint option. These are structures. 25 to 50% has been stiffness has been increased this particular model that they have achieved. Haley is another company where they want to reduce the front bumper location. Okay, so that has been achieved, and this is the optimized structure. This is the final structure. 10% of mass savings they have achieved. And 3D Hub is another company. This is assembly. This is a base design. And the optimized design is this one. And 20% of mass savings they have achieved, and 30% is stronger compared to the base design. Okay. Evenflow is another company for baby chair. They have just, they want to improve the safety of the particular chair, baby chair, and aesthetic designs also should be good with the cushion effects. So that's why they have designed in a very proper way, and they come up with a optimization result at the back support, okay, using a plastic part. 25% is lighter than original part they have achieved. KSS Key Safety Systems, another, so this is the location here. This part, they have optimized it. 50% of mass reduction they have achieved. Sorry, peak displacement reduced by 50%. Aerospace engine bracket, this is a base engine bracket. You can see the location in the first image, okay. Once we applied the boundary loading conditions, the boundary condition is the bottom surface is fixed. They have applied the pressure, 100 PSI pressures on the inner surfaces, and 180 Hertz excitation from high pressure system, 50 Hertz from the low pressure system. They have applied it at this particular cylindrical area. And maroon is design space, gray is non-design space, from which optimization has given like this, the topology result. And using a polyner fine tune, this is a metal printed part. The challenge is all the aerospace parts, they want to replace with additive manufacturing methodology. So they use Inspire structure as a tool, and they got a very good optimized structure, and that is printed using SLM-280 twin loss. So multiple products, they can print it up. 15% of weight reduction, and the porosity is less compared to the original bracket, and the fatigue life is increased by three times. So that is what it has been achieved. The Syntavia is a company of, it is into aerospace engineering. Another institute is called Ryerson International Institute, I can say. They want to design a like landing gear type of part. Okay, so graduated students have been developed this particular equipment. Ryerson University at Toronto is a place. So the competition is SpaceX Hyperloop pod. They have to create it. So they have considered some of the mounting structures where they want to reduce it. The input is motor speed they have given, and that is what the input has given, and the mass is added. The motor mass is added here. The force is applied. Depends on that input. This is my design space. The optimization result has been achieved in this way. And finally, it is printed with a aluminum, silicon, aluminum, silicon, 10 mg. And final prototype is ready, and they have tested it also. So 4 times it is lighter than the baseline model, okay? And machined from solid design. The first satellite antenna, which is optimized, and it is launched in satellite antenna. Rogue Aerospace is one industry. They use InspaStructure as InspaStructure for optimization. Okay, this is another case study. Okay, so first it was the base design was this one, and finally the optimization result is this one, metal printed part to hold the antenna part. Okay, this is also launched automatic. They have assembled it and they have launched it into the space. It has successfully placed part in the, for the antenna holder. It's called Sentinel-1 antenna satellite. What we have achieved from the baseline to the optimized part is 43% weight reduction is achieved, and the eigenfrequency, the natural frequency, has been increased from 70 to 90 hertz. It has improved static behavior of the particular part, strength and stiffness and stability of the part. So it has not only decreased the weight, it has increased the strength, stability and stiffness of the part. EADS, again, it's a European Aerospace Design Center it is. From the original design, it was 918 grams. Optimized design, we got 362 grams. 64% of weight reduction has happened. And they used additive layered manufacturing methodology. So this is another part into automotive in racing cars. This is a bracket. The brackets, different type of brackets you can consider for the lightweight designs, and you can achieve it using InspaStructure's optimization technology. Again, it's into automotive industries. Technish University has been developed. So this is a baseline model. This is an optimized model. 35% of mass reduction, 5 times increase in the stiffness. Using additive manufacturing, they manufacture the part. In the valve also, it's a complex in nature part. In that areas also, it is suggesting the optimized part should be like this. So they have come up with a metal manufacturing using SLM. This is a metal printed part they have assembled in the real life scenario. They saw that the fluid flow in the internal channels has been increased and improved also. And 67% of weight reduction is achieved. So it is meeting the strength requirements and stress requirements of the particular part. Tornado camera bracket. Inspire is for designing the model for additive manufacturing. You can see this particular part, the previous part, and this optimized part. The weight has been reduced. Longitudinal deflection has been reduced. And mass is also reduced about 38%. So in the pistons also, the user has been introduced this particular Inspire tool. So this is optimized structure. This is the final part, prototype. APE works, nothing but Airbus group. For the internal traveling purpose, they have developed a completely metal printed part with welded. Some of the welded locations are there. Inspired by the nature, electric motor, motorcycle goes 3D printed, combining topology optimization and new materials and additive manufacturing techniques into this particular Airbus development. And Airbus AP Works, a light rider results in a revolutionary lightweight design. So the complete frame weight is 6 kgs, complete vehicle kg is 35 kg. It's an electric vehicle. The challenge is the optimized structure should be additive manufactured. So I have considered the sheet metal part first. wherever the non-design space is there, I have captured non-design space. This is my design space, and I have applied the loading conditions. I got the optimized structure in this way that I have done with a polynups using Inspire Studio. I have developed the polynups model, and then I have done a simulation of that. So baseline model and optimized model is showing a very good result. Optimized model is showing a good result, good strength also. So that is what we achieved, and it is live in Airbus group. So a single passenger can sit and they can go anywhere. In civil engineering also we can use this Inspire structure. You can see these kind of structures, optimized structures it has developed, bus shelters. So you can get a concepts by using this particular tool, bridge pillars, how it should be. And for this particular tool, we got so many awards. It's called Golden Mousetrap Award in the 2013. And the Best Architect Show, we got a very good award for Inspire Structure Optimization Result. Materialize is one company for lattice optimization also. Lattice optimization also can carry out in Inspire Structure. Why Inspire? As I said, most of the engineers and industries and companies will benefit to getting a lightweight structure and a stiffened part upfront, going for the traditional way. Customers can develop the best designers at the earliest stages in the design process. It significantly reduces the mass in existing and new parts. And we have a modern user interface where it facilitates quick learning and easy of use in nature. 30 plus years of proven concept. Now it is 30 plus years of proven concept generation technology we have. And interfaces to existing CAD tools. These are the benefits you have. Supporting local languages and trends. 4,000 plus Inspire users trained worldwide. 5,500 plus companies are using Inspire as a tool. In Inspire itself, there are other options called Hypermorph. This is an example of that, a particular Hypermorph. So now, this is the problem definition. This is optimized layout in this particular problem. Developed with, we got the concept design with the help of Inspire, and we used polynups. And the first one is determine the link connection point to achieve desired shaft rotation here. And the second location is to return spring preload necessary to sustain torsion spring preload. Whatever the preload is available, rotation due to this rotation, what is a that is they want to simulate it. So we need to determine the effort force required to actuate the lever. So how much force is required to lift this particular lever? That you want to understand, right? So you want to do a kinematic simulation for that. You have to do that. Okay, the fourth part is optimal structural design of lever. Still any fine tuning is required that we have to do. Evaluate various optimized lever designs. We need to do it, nothing but shape optimization, considering the manufacturing issues and 3D print. This is an example of a complete lever mechanism. Okay, so creating a sub-assembly for the lever components, and we do optimization for that. How we have achieved that optimization, we are getting here. So we are doing a partitions for that. Non-design space for the cylindrical holes. I'll skip this one. This is an optimized model. Okay. So once this is done, you can get into the morphing technologies. So morphing tools, nothing but you can pick the nodes and you can drag. You can see free morphing videos, how easily we can morph the existing designs. This is again a new technology, I can say, in the industries. No need of remodifying the designs in the CAD software. Directly existing measured model itself, you can morph it. Okay, which will save a lot of time to the industries and the design engineers as well. Okay. So generally what we do in the previous things is we'll modify the design in CAD software. Again, you'll come and you do the remesh. Here it is not required, that all steps are included here. Here itself, you can modify the meshes. On the mesh itself, you can modify. So you are reducing a lot of time. It may be a 2D mesh or it may be a 3D mesh. Okay, if you want to stretch that shape, okay, you can also manually also you can morph and place it at the circular hole centers. Okay, and you can decrease the height, width. You can use it. So mesh is not disturbing here. You can see that element quality is also good. So this is why the so many automotive industries are coming up with new cars in a very less time. In 6 months frame, they are coming with a new cars because they are modifying in this similar way and they are doing simulations. This is a new trend again in the market. So if you have a new geometry, directly the elements whatever is there, you can map it. This is called hypermorph. Okay, it may be a 3D or a 2D. You can map these particular nodes, whatever the selected is there. You can just select that and say morph. So the shape is changed. So ambassador to a Maruti Suzuki, like that kind of modifications you can do with the help of morphing. So it's called morphogenius, realistic morphogenius. You can do it. You're working on the nodes and faces. Hypermorph is another module in Altair HyperWorks. For research studies also, it is very useful. So whenever you want to research on the particular design shapes, okay, so that also you can do it. There is a cage morphing. You can define a cage. In that cage itself, you can modify it. Yeah, this is a complete cage. Okay, this is called cage morphing. Coming to InspireCast, okay, the challenges of soon I'll complete this one. The product highlights of this InspireCast is you can do all high pressure die casting. You can simulate it. Okay, low pressure, gravity casting, sand casting, inclined sand casting, that all simulations you can carry out. The main challenges is power, cost, weight, speed, accuracy, and strength, any design. So once the optimization is done, you can go for the casting simulation and you check the manufacturability feasible using the InspireCast. So once that is done, so that is why we call as generate, analyze, and simulate it. So we have generating a conceptual design. So I shown Inspire structure, analyzing the structures. Inspire structure is option. Simulate manufacturing process is nothing but InspireCast. Once you do it. Okay, so this is a complete design environment of Inspire tool. Okay, you have a motions, you have a structure optimization, you have a rendering tool, you have a fluids. Okay, electroflow is one thing is available where you can do electronic cooling. So you can also carry out casting simulation, injection molding, forming, sheet metal forming, die extrusions, additive manufacturing. We support all these trends like digital manufacturing, what we call as, right? In the system simulation itself, you can carry out all the manufacturing simulation parts and you can get very easy, accurate, and affordable simulations using InspireCast, InspireForm. Okay, quickly I'll run through because the time is up as per the agenda. So this is about the complete detailed casting simulations part. Okay, so when you go through the setup, you will have once you import the geometry, you define the gates, input and output, and set up the process and run the simulation. So it's very simply. I'll quickly run this particular video where you can understand the process of casting simulation. Okay, once you import the model, okay, we are checking the first feasible studies, nothing but the casting feasible studies. So you are creating a gates. So to understand this particular gate, chiller, okay, you need to understand the casting methodology, casting manufacturing methodology. So once that is filled, so the core is filled and gates are done and the original part is there. So now you are going for the risers. You're adding the risers. You can increase by push and pull options, as I said in Inspire. Once that is done, you can create a mold in one click. And you can see the gravity process. It may be a filling time, or you can plot and you can do the simulation. So once the simulation is done, this is nothing but how it is filling, flow front, temperature, all outputs you'll get it once the simulation is done. Velocities and filling times, cut sections, pressures, cold sheds, solidification, liquid fraction, solid times, total porosity of the part, section views, you can plot. And you can understand, okay, if I go for the original manufacturing, what are the defects are affecting my design, so that you can understand in the first cut simulation, and then you will modify it. So all type of casting simulations you can carry out. So accurate capturing of defects. So this is what the air gaps it is having. So nothing but total shrinkage of the material here. So these are the issues we'll have in the casting process that you can find out very easily in the tool. And then you'll modify by adding some risers, chillers, gateways in different locations. And you'll understand, okay, you'll suggest to the manufacturer, boss, this is the way. This is where you need to apply the risers, chillers, and everything. Depends on that, you'll get a good output of the model. So that is what it helps you. Okay, so this I'll skip it up. These are anyways, it is there in Altair website. Inspire form, as I said, again, I'll skip this one because, you know, Inspire form, it's a sheet metal forming. A streamlined stamping simulation software, which will helpful to understand the feasible study, again, manufacturing feasible study for multiple stage virtual tryout. As I said, nesting also. Once you do the sheet metal forming, it will show you the FLD diagram, strain, minor strain versus major strain. It will show you the contour here. The failure locations are red areas. Green is a safer side. So this is the curve it will show you. So wherever the red areas are there, it's nothing but failure locations. You need to add a thickness of that. So this is how you'll understand the first cut simulations. Okay. So it will understand before going to the original manufacturing, you can do it here itself and you can understand. Okay, so as I said, these are the nestings. In a single sheet, how many parts we can stamp it together. So material database is inbuilt with US, Japanese, and European standards. Okay, import the geometry, set up the model, analyze the formability studies, flatten and fit blanket, nest blanket. So this blanket in a single sheet, one of the diameter is there, one of the dimensions are there. Within that, how many I can print, so that you can estimate here itself in the Inspire form and forming up. Simple video I can showcase. They are using stamping simulation, thinning percentage. Okay, formability studies, it will show you nesting information, cost estimation also, it will give it to you. Carrier information, nesting information, and cost estimation for the future development. Virtual tryout, incremental. You can carry out. Tryout workflow is this one, import model, set up a drawing, analyze the drawing, set up trimming and spring back, analyze the spring back simulation and forming. So these are about the tryouts, simulations. Okay. It's very user-friendly tools, all are these. In a single environment, you can carry out multiple simulations. Inspire Extrusion, again, it's a very good tool for a die extrusion simulations. Okay, so fast, easy, and accurate, and affordable. So it allows the users to enhance and optimize the extrusion process for massively improving productivity and quality. So most of the aluminum frames for the windows or office structures, they will keep some aluminum frames, right, to hold the glass. So these are all structures will be manufactured with the help of die extrusions. So the first cut die extrusions, you can go. So original manufacturing, if you go, it will fail. The dies will fail. So in Hyderabad, Satya Surya Aluminium, Global Aluminium, Alstom. So all these customers are using this die extrusion simulation, and NFC also, Nuclear Fuel Complex, also using die extrusion simulation. It's called Hyper Extrude. It is Inspire Extrude. Simple environment. Okay. So these are the default failures, the challenges in failures in the manufacturing locations. So these are the defaults which are appeared in the simulation. So before going to the original manufacturing itself, you are understanding this. So that is how you can eliminate the time, like whatever the time wastage you are doing at the original manufacturing, before itself you are doing that trials in the system simulation using a digital simulation softwares. Okay, this is how the extrusion comes. You see this using the die, it will come. We'll show you overheating and profile quality, all you can capture it. Bad seam welds, okay, unable, unbalanced bearings are there, die wear, okay, broken contamination, all you can visualize it in the results, die extrusion results. Profile distortion, generally it happens like this. So the same similar kind of complex scenarios you can capture in Inspire Extrude. Okay, this is what the profile with varying thickness, this is what we have achieved, original to realistic. Okay, simulation to the realistic thing. These are the examples. Unbalanced bearing, so wherever the unbalanced locations are there, it will capture it. And you can correct it after these particular simulations. Okay, bearing optimization. Once you do initial bearing is this one, optimized bearing is this location here. That also can do it here, bearing optimization in the Inspire Extrude itself. So premature failure of die leads to a loss of productivity. So that kind of issues will be there when you do extrusion. Inspire Extrude helps to identify regions of high stresses concentration. So before going to the original extrude manufacturing, it will suggest you whether the die is good or not. In the CAD, whatever the CAD you do it, right? It will suggest you these are the modifications needed areas. So user design engineer has to modify that areas. So before going to the original extrusion manufacturing, in the design itself, it will suggest you these are the modifications you have to do. Once you do the modifications, again, you can check that region, whether it is having high stress concentration areas or not, that you can check. Preliminary check, you can do it, and then you can go for the extrusion process. It will help you. Okay. So you can see that peak stresses we observed with the default one is 2750. New design die after suggesting by the Inspire Extrude, the peak stress is 1125 stresses. So contamination, so much wastage will happen in the extrusion industries. So to avoid these kind of wastages, use a system simulation tools called Inspire Extrude, where they can develop their own extrusion methodology for smoother their work. The metal will come outside. So this is the die shape, right? So once it is billet is heated and it is melted, it is pushing it, right? So metal will come in that way. So back-end defects, skin impurities, that will come. Charge weld defects, all these are the technical words about the extrusion methodologies. Okay, numerical and experimental comparison. So these are numerical A profile and these are simulation profiles. So it meets your current requirement, old and new. If you compare, we are very, very accurate results you are getting. Experimental and numerical, you can see. Seam welds also it will suggest, accurately predicts the weld regions and strength in the part. And seam weld locations and weld strength calculations also can carry out. So these are the some of the structures. This is the theory behind that extrusion. I'll skip this one. And apart from that extrusion, we have. So using Inspire, you'll get virtual, which is a virtual tool which helps to identify the defects in the defects in the die design, defects in the extrusion methodology. In the first cut scenario, you can find it out, and then you can improve the die designs, and you can get the results accurate. Once you do the simulations, you modify it, and you'll get an accurate design. You'll get it. That design you can give it to the manufacturer for the original manufacturing of the part. So the next is additive manufacturing part. So this I'll skip it up. So additive manufacturing means whoever has a metal printing machine, they can use additive manufacturing. So this is called a digital manufacturing method also. As I said, in digital manufacturing, there are three methods. One is product lifecycle management, where system designs will use it. This also comes as a smart factory. Machineries are required, that is SLM, Renishaw. Okay, once this part is done, it's nothing but a 3D printing process planning simulation it is. So once the part is ready, you are understanding the preparation of that particular part, what is the best orientation. In the 3D printing, actually the supporting structure is very important. Support structures should be very less. It should not waste much. So to understand that, you can do this particular tool. It's called Inspire Print 3D. You can do thermomechanical analysis. Layer by layer, it will be using a powder metal. Once it is doing a layer by layer, where are the higher stresses are appearing, where is the defects in the 3D printing as well, that you can find it out. So it's a 3D printing process planning simulation tool, Inspire Print 3D. Okay, and maximum deformation after printing, you can check it up. This is the maximum deformation, and stress map also you can carry out, and you can check where are the high stresses locations, and the plastic strain mapping, where are the plastic strain mapping also you can understand it. So the complete setup. So what this setup helps 3D printing industries is supporting structure, how to reduce the supporting structure, the wastage of that particular material, it will help you. Which is the best orientation for 3D printing that it will suggest you. Okay, and before going to the original manufacturing itself, in the 3D printing, you are doing the simulation here itself and finding out the defects. Once you find the defects, you are modifying that particular design, and again you are doing the rerunning of the 3D printing process planning. So this is how you'll reduce a lot of time or a lot of cost to the industries. So these are the tools which are available in digital systems, digital manufacturing systems. So these tools will be helpful for the industries. So as per the today's topic, that is why I have covered all these Inspire tools, which are into digital technologies in design and manufacturing systems. If you see my slides also, from the designing, means parametric design onwards to the manufacturing, we covered. So Haltair is the right partner to help you compete with the compete in this future with the help of we also support Internet of Things, additive manufacturing, machine learning, e-mobility, cloud computing, and smart product designs. So Haltair is into these particular technologies as well. And by this, I'll end my session of this particular today's session, like digital technologies in design and manufacturing systems. And thank you one and all for attending this particular section. Thank you, Srinidhi Engineering College, Mechanical Department, and complete principal, sir, a complete whole team of Srinidhi. Thank you one and all once again. If you have any doubts, please raise your queries so that I can answer it.
Yeah, Mr. Karthik, this is Dr. Jay Kiran. I have few questions on this.
Please, sir, please ask us.
Well, I must really thank you for all the, you have given them a very good session, length and breadth of the software. Okay, anyway, can you please compare analysis part of this software with the ANSYS one? Because we are all familiar with the ANSYS, but we never used the simulation part on this. Can you please compare how good it is with you?
Sir, we have did all these iterations because NAFEMS India, you heard about NAFEMS India, sir?
Yes. Hello. Yes.
Yeah, NAFEMS India is a globally certified company who certifies all these CAE analysis results.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. They will certify, then only it will release into the market. So NAFEMS has certified this particular tool called Inspire Structure. All this Inspire Casting or Inspire Manufacturing topics, whatever I've covered, the tools are all are certified with the NAFEMS. And one more thing, comparing the results. So when you are doing apple to apple comparison, definitely it will match, sir. When you are doing apple to lemon, it will not. We cannot compare it. So fine, your results will be accurate, no doubt in that, because we are using second order tetrahedral element at the background. Okay, so we'll get more accurate results. As a CAD engineer, he is not visible about the meshing part. Okay, meshing is taken care of by the software itself directly at the background.
But
so any CAD engineer can use this one. Yeah.
Personally, I feel when we have the control on the meshing, we may have get the better results, right?
Correct. But this is especially for CAD engineers. We have developed these particular tools.
Okay.
Again, you want to do any detailed stress analysis, you should go for the ANSYS or our tool called OptiStruct or Radios. You can use it for detailed stress analysis or material geometric nonlinearities. For that additional analysis, you can carry.
Okay, thank you. And one more question from my side. I hope you know what is macro programming and all, right? In the softwares like SolidWorks or CATIA and the other way, we can automate the complete process of it, right? We'll be calling it macro programming. I missed that. Can you please tell that? How can we program?
Yeah, in this particular tools, whichever I have shown you, okay? The user has to do all the steps, okay? There is no macro programming options are available in this. There is other module called SimLab ST. I can say SimLab ST is another tool in Altair portfolio, which is a multi-physics simulation tool. Okay. And if you have a larger assembly, it's like 10,000 parts or 1 lakh parts. Most of the time is like committed for the pre-processing itself, right? It will take a lot of time for the pre-processing itself. That for that pre-processing, we have automated automation tools are available in SimLab ST.
Okay.
So that tool has an automation like macros. Hypermesh also has a macros. Like OptiStruct also has a macros. So now you want to do once I import the geometry, it should automatically does mid-surface generation, meshing, solving the problem. Okay. Solving you keep it aside, but after the meshing, you have a macros are available in Altair Suite, in Hypermesh.
Yeah.
The programming part is also there.
Yeah, I want to read some questions from the chat as well. This is by Mr. Arun Kumar BVS. He is asking you, sir, how much does it cost for a 1 year license?
You want which particular product? You saw all the products, right?
Okay, I don't know. He just asked the same, sir.
This how much the does the 1 year lease license cost? Yeah. It's only for one user you're asking or two users? One user means it comes around 3 lakhs plus taxes, I can say. It may come down also, depends on the budget, whatever you have. It's an open forum, I should not tell, but I have some idea, rough idea, I'm telling, as a technical engineer.
Yeah, the next question below to that is in research oriented, how to buy the full research version?
Yeah, research version, we have a full version of Altair product. If you go to Altair HyperWorks, okay, so there are multiple portfolios are available.